make a good future for the coming generations, we have to be very, very serious about United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. And here, the ocean is part of the solutions if we care for ocean management. And one of the key elements is ocean data, and ocean data sharing is critical. And we have very little time.
Technology shapes the way we live, learn, and work. Capgemini is a global leader in AI and data, has responsibility and the commitment to address the sustainability challenge that we're facing today. Capgemini's Global Data Science Challenge is an annual company-wide hackathon that draws on our purpose to ensure a sustainable future for our planet through our skills, energy, and the drive of more than 290,000 talented employees around the world. We provide them with the tools to learn about deep technology for sensor data analytics on a major cloud data platform with AWS, and put this into practice with real-life use cases. Linking to the United Nations Decade of Ocean Science for Sustainable Development, this year Capgemini teamed up with Lofoten Vesteren LoVe Ocean Observatory, which provides unique continuous online data about the local ocean environment.
LoVe is our eyes and ears in the sea. The system consists of a fiber optic subsea cables and sensors nodes which cover a large area from land to the deep sea. It's like an internet on the seabed. The continuous stream of complex sensor data leads to a large data volume. New automated methods are therefore urgently needed to help the research community unlock the full benefit of the data.
The Lofoten Vesterålen Cable Observatory, it can monitor both plankton and fish stocks, and it measures also the salinity and the temperature and the current. We now are going to watch and to explore the consequences and give good climate predictions. These time series are of absolutely crucial value. And the ocean is part of the solution, but it will not be part of the solution if we do not manage our ocean in a sustainable way.
There were several approaches that the teams picked out that we are now looking into. For example, whale vocalization, oceanographic and tidal features we hadn't yet recognized, and the strong influence of weather on the distribution of individual organisms. The next step for us is to deploy and test the methods proposed by the winning teams of the LoVe Ocean Observatory servers to tap the full potential of the methods.
The ocean is too big to ignore, not too big to fail, but also currently not too big to fix. Through close partnerships and the collaboration, we can make a meaningful, measurable impact in tackling climate change. Together, we will get a future we want for our people, our society, and our planet.